So, hey everyone, I'm Sean. I'm here at Iron Horse Motorcycles in Monroe, North Carolina. So we're having a Women's Day today. So while all the other folks are out there on their ride for the other fallen rider, we haven't quite gotten to the point where we're ready for the 3 o'clock women's ride just yet. So in the meantime, we have with us Rebecca. Rebecca is actually going to be, or she's one of the hosts today for the women's ride. So we're gonna just chit chat with her and find out what it is that you know, she has to tell us, and find out a little bit about who she is, and also, well, what about this whole being a woman rider? What's up with this woman's ride day? So Rebecca, who are you?
So my name's Rebecca. I've worked here at Iron Horse in sales for almost 5 years. I've been riding for about 7. I actually bought my first motorcycle here. It was a Shadow 1100, and bought my last one here, which was a Harley Road Glide, and I've been in love with it ever since. I wanted to teach a class for women riders on tips and tricks, things they might not know. A lot of women I've found in sales feel very intimidated with other experienced bike riders, especially their males in their life, brothers, husbands, fathers. They just don't have that same ease into comfort, I guess, sometimes. And I found that when you have women instructors, it tends to make people feel a little bit more comfortable. Mm-hmm. And I thought, I'd love to do a free class teaching people how to ride, what to do, and then going on a ride afterwards. I do cater to the lowest skill level on my ride, so whether you're new or experienced, it's just a good way to get together with other women riders on the same skill level as you, mm-hmm. which is ultimately the goal for this class, is to link up other women with same size bikes, similar riding styles, similar areas that they live in,
right.
and just putting women together with other women to ride, and really just, we're a minority in this industry, and it's we're a fast-growing one. And now that they've come out with three-wheelers and certain automatic bikes, it's opened it up to even more women who previously didn't think they could ride. But I love empowering women and helping women. And so motorcycles is kind of my thing. And
yeah.
if I can teach somebody something, and if you can teach me something, we can all learn from each other. But yeah, I like to ride and ride with the girls, and today we're going to go for a nice little Morrow Mountain ride up at a state park, so.
Awesome. So how did you get into motorcycles?
Long story short, I went on a mission trip, saw a bunch of scooters, wanted a scooter, came home, reevaluated the scooter situation, decided a motorcycle was a little more okay. my speed, bought a motorcycle, didn't even know how to ride, had them deliver it, had them ride me around the block. And then I've just been putting miles on it ever since.
Awesome. So I'm assuming you obviously took the MSF course.
Yes.
Now, are you a safety instructor or no?
No, I am not.
Okay, but you have taken the advanced course and you just love it so much.
I did. I have taken the basic and the advanced, which I highly recommend for anyone, even if you know how to ride. The things that they teach you in those courses are really invaluable on the street. Plus, if you didn't know, most car insurances, motorcycle insurances, give you a good driver's discount because it is considered a good driver safety course. So if you do have any of those certificates, I would recommend contacting your insurance, and I get a 10% discount with Progressive.
Right.
Who, if you need insurance advice, I have a couple really good insurance companies I can recommend based off experience with claims and customer service, but I highly recommend taking not only the basic, but also the advanced rider's class.
Awesome, awesome. So today, what are you gonna be teaching us?
Today we're gonna go over some basics. We're gonna go over how to check your oil, how to change your oil. It's a lot easier than people realize, and it can save about 50%, and you can do it in your home without having to make an appointment. Simple things like tire PSI. A lot of people don't understand why it matters or what kind of pressure you need in your tires. I'm also gonna go over today how to hit some stuff in the road like gravel or grass. People like to mow their grass and don't realize it's not only illegal, but it's extremely dangerous for bikers to hit grass. So I'm gonna go over basically today some bike maintenance, bike safety, and road safety in general. It'll be about a 30 to 45 minute class.
Nice.
And then we'll go out on the road and we'll take a couple stops and take people's inventory for how they feel and what else we can all share with each other.
Absolutely. So what do you notice most? I mean, obviously you've been working at Iron Horse for a little while, What do you notice most about women motorcyclists when they try to come in here and purchase their first bikes?
A lot of them are intimidated, and that's sad, but a lot of them I feel come in here and they're kind of afraid to ask questions. They want to know stuff, but they don't want to ask, say, just for example, the man in their life, because they feel, you know, sometimes you just want to do stuff on your own and you don't want a man to help you.
Yeah.
And we don't need men to help us. We can ride just like the rest of them. There's certain things that it's just easier to have a woman show you how to do. We have different, what is that called?
I mean, we have a lot of things that are different, right? I mean, obviously the body styles are different, you know, some of the concerns and challenges are different. I mean, you know, some of the basic things that we think about and the way you ride, our structure, the way you lean or don't lean, the way you actually handle the bike, a lot of those things are going to be different from a male to a female. So it's just a matter of being comfortable sometimes on whatever it is you're riding and learning how to ride that best.
Exactly.
So I don't know.
Exactly. It's, motorcycle riding is kind of similar to weightlifting. We are both one structure, but we have different muscle components that work in different areas.
Right.
And motorcycle riding is not so much about manhandling or steering as it is about leaning, and that's one thing a lot of people don't realize, men or women, is counter steering and leaning is your best friend.
It's funny because I compare motorcycle riding to like a dance.
Yes.
Right?
Yes.
So it's like you dance, you have the option sometimes. If you're just kind of playing around, you can use your hips if you want to, right?
Yes.
Or
I agree.
If you want to lean a little bit here, lean a little bit there, you know, you just kind of get the feel for your bike, and that's how you know you're kind of at one your bike, and you're able to do what you need to do with that and just feel like it's a dance, whether you're following
it
lines
is.
And a curve. So I was up in the mountains in Robbinsville like a few weeks ago, and one of the things you couldn't help but do is going back and forth in the mountains. I mean, that was like the ultimate dance, because as soon as you hit one curve, you're going ready to prepare for another one. And when you think about it, it's like a little wave, right? And when you're actually most comfortable and most confident, you're just able to ride the wave.
And that's what I want to do. I want to help enable women, give them the knowledge. Because you have to have knowledge before you can have power.
Absolutely.
And if you have the knowledge how to handle the motorcycles, and I recommend personally, if you have anyone with different motorcycles, ride every motorcycle that anyone will let you, because you'll learn different styles. You'll learn, even if you know that that's not for you, well, now you just learned it's not for you. But you learn your style, you learn your partner, and I love the dance. Yes, it
absolutely.
Is. It's totally,
absolutely.
It's totally a dance.
Now, one of the things we were talking about earlier was the misconception that, you know, every woman can do everything with every bike, right? And one of the things we were talking about, which I'll demonstrate at some point, not today, is picking up a motorcycle.
Once it's fallen.
Once it's fallen, picking up a motorcycle. And yes, absolutely. There are some women that are like really small that can pick up really heavy bikes. Mm-hmm. And there are some women who are, you know, not so small, but you know, those bikes, it's not always the same. So I know with me, my bike is like 450 pounds, right? My older one was like about 3-something, you know, and that was wet. But at the same time, there's definitely a difference in how you pick it up. So obviously the lighter one was a lot easier, but it also depends on the point of where you're trying to pick it up and what points you have on those bikes and how much you're able to grasp, your body style, your height. There are a lot of factors that go into it. So it's not going to be the same thing for every single person.
And don't feel bad if you can't pick up your bike. I'm 6 feet tall and I have a 900 pound road glide. I cannot pick it up if I drop it. And I've heard numerous times you shouldn't ride a bike that you can't pick up. I'm going to just throw that out the window, because I can ride any motorcycle and I can't pick up most of them. It's just not, but that doesn't discredit my qualifications as a rider or anybody else's just because you can't pick it up. We are structurally different than men, so men think it's a lot easier just to pick it up, and it's like, well, we're just not built the same. So if you drop your bike and you can't pick it up, definitely don't let that discourage you, because you're not alone. There's a lot of experienced riders that can't pick up their bike, but there are some great videos out there that show you how, and I would highly suggest, there's a couple different techniques. I will tell you, the shorter you are, the easier you're gonna have it, but there's definitely some good videos that show you how to pick up bikes, so I would highly encourage checking those out after.
Absolutely. So what else do you find challenging when it comes to women riders when they're first starting out? Are there any habits that we have that I'm not aware of just yet?
So some of the biggest things that hold women riders up, I'm going to say, are more to do with themselves and their insecurities and lack of experience than something that actually comes through with the bike. One thing I've noticed is a lot of women are a little more cautious than men in general, and when you're insecure about the bike or you don't know your bike, you're gonna have a lot more difficult time learning that dance and feeling comfortable. What I recommend for anybody with a bike is to have a lot of saddle time, whether you're driving or you're sitting in your garage watching a show on YouTube. You just want to sit on that bike, build that muscle memory, sway it from side to side, just let the bike completely feel like an extension of your body. That's the biggest thing I think most women could do to make themselves better riders, is to build up their confidence. I recommend watching a lot of motorcycle videos. I recommend watching crash videos. And I know that sounds crazy, but if you know what you don't want to do or what to expect, it's kind of like some of the things I go over in my class. Nobody wants to hit a dog or a deer, but it's going to happen. That's going to happen too. It's going to happen. And when it does, you want to make sure that you're properly trained for it. Sorry, we're in a bike shop. There's going to be lots of interruptions.
That's okay. Well, you know, I think that's a really good point. I mean, one, you obviously, when people tell you something, you might again, I'm not going to say take it with a grain of salt, but if you want to ride a motorcycle, ride a motorcycle.
Yes.
When I first told people I was going to go across country and I was going to go ahead of everyone else and, you know, head up the Flagstaff and just meet everyone there, you know, the looks I got, I'm like, wait, what? You know, who's going with you? I'll just go ahead and go. It's just a motorcycle, just like anything else. And you go. But, you know, I do recall there was one person that said, just go. You know, you'll be okay. I mean, you know what kind of person you are. It's okay. So I think having that confidence and definitely, you know, believing in yourself and believing that, you know, you can do this. It's nothing like, you know, there are a whole bunch of motorcycles out there. This is not rocket science. It's just a matter of actually believing yourself, feeling comfortable with the motorcycle that you're on. And, you know, again, that little seat time, that saddle time, there is no comparison for it. Because when you actually start getting in the seat, you become more familiar with your bike, you start understanding, you know, the ticks and this and that, and how it leans, and because of the weight of the bike, which is so crucial, you know, to the actual body style that you have, it's going to be absolutely essential. Because when I first started riding, I was on an SC650. That was great, you know. I mean, it was great. It was really nimble. It was great in turn. Oh, that bike was beautiful. But then after I got tired of getting left and I upgraded to the R1, the weight was so different. It's like going into a curve. It was so much, it was a different weight that I had to lean into it. And it was just, I used more of my hips, or I used different body parts in order to kind of get make the same impact and make sure I'm clearing everything I need to clear. And when I got back on the SV, you know, after riding the R1, it felt like a scooter. Yep. Because, you know, if I moved my hips one way or the next, it would be completely different. I'd probably be out in the woods someplace. So you have to be familiar with what you're doing.
Ride your ride, learn your ride, ride as many other bikes as you can, and any free time you have. I spend a lot of free time with my bike in the garage. I mean, we have a personal relationship. And I think that's really important to have. You need to know your bike. You need to know, if you have a Harley, you need to know where the drips are coming from. I mean, it's, you know, I love my Harley, but it leaks sometimes. And I need to make sure that's a good leak or an okay leak, or I need to pull over leak. And I definitely recommend the most important thing, like she said, is get to know your bike.
Absolutely.
Just like any relationship, any dance, mm-hmm. It's get to know your partner, because ultimately you need to have a healthy respect and fear for it, mm-hmm. But you're in charge.
Absolutely. That's a great analogy. You know, your bike is really your partner, because, you know, you have to be able to listen to each other, communicate to each other, and whatever it's trying to tell you, you got to be open to, you know, getting that feedback and understanding, okay, this is just nothing, or no, I have to do something about this.
I agree.
It's important.
And maybe we could get some feedback on the ride when we get to our stop, and you can ask the women if they have any questions, and go from there.
That'd be great. So if you're going to see some pictures all around. So we are in the Iron Horse Motorcycle Museum. They have all kinds of cool motorcycles up on the wall and everything else like that.
They all run.
Really?
They were all built by the owner or his brother. Mm-hmm. A lot of them have been in magazines, catalogs, calendars, TV shows. Yeah.
I have no idea.
We have the second museum in North Carolina. The first is Wheels Through Time in Maggie Valley. But, I mean, we've got a decent a decent little collection here.
It's a very good collection here. I'm definitely going to have to post some pictures of all the stuff they have here.
Yeah.
All right. Well, I'm going to tell you now, it's been great being over here with Iron Horse. You guys have been absolutely daggone hospitable.
We appreciate you coming.
Oh, yeah. It's been great. I'm glad to be here. I mean, just to kind of get up in this part of North Carolina. Obviously, I'm down in the Raleigh area, so it's a little bit more flat down there.
Oh, you'll like our little ride. We'll have a little bit of, we'll have little twisties.
Excellent. I'm looking forward to it. But I mean, everyone's been so great. Everyone's really, really awesome. And when I look at the, when I did the tour of the facilities, oh my gosh, this place is massive.
It's huge.
Absolutely massive, but I mean, it's a great place.
And it's been family owned since, well, the current owner, Mike and Nikki, have owned it since 81, but they had partially owned it even back in the 70s. So we've been a mom and pop family bike shop, and customers come first, their family. I bought my first bike here, and 3 years later, I got a job here, and I've been here ever since. And yeah.
All right. Well, thank you, Rebecca. It's been great just talking to you, and I look forward to the ride.
I know, me too.
All right. Take care, everyone. Bye-bye.
Thanks.